friends of the board.
Vigilante activity is on the rise in Gotham.
Crime scene? Cool. But what about your photographic memory?
Cold case. When I wasn't there, it helps to see it laid out.
The detail is incredible. Commissioner Gordon?
Detective Gordon, at the time.
You made it look just like his statue.
Now that we know about the court, I thought I might be able to close a few of his unsolved cases.
Solid thinking. Oh, I'll help.
I'm good. I'll let you know if I find anything.
It's fine. Two heads are better than one.
I'm sorry. I'd like to do this myself.
Sure. Let me know if you need anything.
All right, Belfry, where am I headed?
By cross-referencing the isotope in the key with Gotham architecture records, we've managed to narrow it down to a location. I'm sending you the coordinates now.
Great. Thanks, Belfry.
Hidden. Remember the court rhyme. The Court of Owls is watching.
From inside Gotham's walls. Got it. Nothing good ever came from an eerie glow. This must be it. There we go. Belfry, I'm in. Looks to be some sort of court hideout. It's empty.
Strange location for it. Any indication of what they were doing there?
Let me take a look. Moreno. I remember that case. Belfry, can you call up the Moreno murder case? Should be in the unsolved file.
Of course. The brother of Elena Moreno, a local judge. She took a leave of absence from the bench directly afterward for family reasons.
It was a Court of Owls hit. Let me see what else I can find out.
Thank you.
Belfry, looks like the court gave an order to purge at the Chelsea Tunnel.
Construction on the tunnel was shut down when the site was declared unsafe.
Sounds like a cover-up to me. Whatever is down there, the Court of Owls wants it kept hidden. I'll head there now.
Take care, and keep us updated. Belfry, I'm in. Looks like they hit some kind of underground tunnel. I'll probably lose comms down there. Mark my location. I'll check in as soon as I can. Sure. Just don't make me come down there after you.
You've got to be kidding me. This place is huge.
Yeah.
I wish you could see this, Belfry. The court's spending a lot of resources to mine whatever's down here. They already extracted what was in here. Maybe I can find a sample with some ore still in it. Extraction room. That sounds promising. No one around. Maybe now I can get a sample of whatever they're mining down here. Maybe these samples can tell me what they're looking for. Thank you. Dionysium? What the hell is that? Maybe the back computer will have some answers. If I ever find my way out of here. That'll get me out of here.
You're still alive. It's clear you don't understand your place. We earned our power. We shaped Gotham into the great city she is today. We are the protectors, not you. You're just bats. And owls devour bats.
Thank you.
Something's blocking the door. Probably debris from the cave-in. Not out of the woods yet. Belfry, you there?
We seem to have you back, Batgirl. Are you all right?
I'm fine. The court is mining some strange substance, and it looks a hell of a lot like... Belfry, you're cutting out. Belfry?
You take forever to do the simplest of tasks. We have things to discuss. Come find me.
The Court of Owls is watching. From inside of Gotham's walls. They lurk in every shadow. And they rule you. One and all.
You used us. You knew about the Court and waited for us to do the dirty work for you.
When I was still part of the League, we observed the court's growth in Gotham. Now you can see the city's rotten core.
They call what they're mining Dionysium. But it looks like it's from a Lazarus pit.
A foul substitute for the true miracle. A contaminated extract. For centuries, the court has been looking for a fountain of youth. Instead, they found the makings of undying monsters.
So those talons, that's what they're using to create them. So why not make a trade? A Lazarus pit for their science. You'd have a loyal army without ever recruiting another ninja.
Even in their current debased state, the League would never descend to such venality. And the court's greed and corruption prevent them from ever mastering the secrets of the Lazarus Pits.
Of course, you get to use the Lazarus Pits because you're so generous and kind.
Oh, those are some harsh words. I gave you back your friend, Jason.
I knew it, and I know you didn't do it as some kind of favor to me. Or Bruce.
I suppose gratitude was too much to expect in exchange for another stab at life.
He didn't ask for your help, Talia. None of us did.
With Bruce gone, the court's operation grows. The League of Shadows will raise Gotham to the ground unless you silence the court.
Just spit it out, Talia. You want the voice gone, and you want to use us to do it for you. But what do you get out of it?
I'll do what I can to distract the League. And your path to the Court of Owls will be clear.
Oh, now I get how Montoya feels.
Hey, Alfred, did the city records turn up anything?
They didn't. According to the city permits, there's been no mining in Gotham City since the cauldron was completed.
Judging from what we found last night, they've been digging down there for centuries.
Give this a listen, Alfred. Babs managed to repair some of the court voice recordings.
Dionysium brought the Talons back to life.
Sort of. Dionysium's basically weak as hell Lazarus pit water. Brings back motor functions. But free will's as good as gone.
So what is a Talon exactly? Some kind of feral zombie assassin?
We've all seen weirder shit. Maybe.
Feral zombie? Sounds like Jason, all right.
I recognize a voice. The older woman is Constance Cobblepot, I'm fairly certain.
And the others?
More difficult to say. Maybe if I heard them in person.
In person? Tim, put the waveforms on the screen.
It's hard to find a match with all the damage and voice modulation. Maybe the matching system would have better luck if...
We match what we have against the live voices.
Fun, but how do we find these jackasses?
Two words. Orchard Hotel.
The Masquerade. The event of the season. This year's dedicated to Master Bruce.
Gotham's rich dress up and pretend they're humanitarians. I've been a few times.
So it's Dirtbag Central.
With so many of Gotham's elite together, security at the Masquerade will be tight. Finding out their plans first would give you an important advantage.
I'll tweak our masks to record telescopic audio.
If we can get a good vantage point, we may be able to put some faces to these mystery voices.
Sounds like our kind of party. I added new evidence to the board.
I leveraged a mutual acquaintance. The head of security for the Orchard Hotel, Mr. Hendricks, has agreed to a meeting. The details are pinned to the evidence board.
Thank you. I've always heard the Orchard Hotel is haunted. That's true at least one night a year.
Physical and mental preparation go hand in hand. Here, we can train the mind to prepare the body. But it requires deep focus. Let go of your pain, and pay attention to my voice.
Definitely something over there.
Who do you think you're doing?
As expected. Well done. Your enemies will exploit mistakes like this. Again. You're better than that.
Here. Maybe you can just call it a night? How could you just let me go? You don't want to do this. Great! Just great! You wanted to throw in the towel. You could have just done so. Get back here, Scuzzy! Where'd she go?
I expect no less. Jim would be proud of you.
Not only is the court real, but so are Talons.
I thought they'd be more, I don't know, intelligent? They're supposed to be the court's greatest weapon.
It's more difficult to control someone capable of free will.
Or anyone able to think at all.
But that doesn't mean we can underestimate them. They are still capable fighters.
Sure. I just won't try to have a conversation with them.
Don't forget that you have a rendezvous with Mr. Hendricks.
Acknowledge, Belfry. They can't have gone far.
Suspicious activity reported. Officers advised to use caution.
And that's Hendrix.
We need officers near the Gotham Naval Research Facility.
Court goons. Hendrix has to be here somewhere.
Whoever's out there, I knocked out one guy, but there's more of them.
Guys to deal with. They can't have gone far.
Known criminals have been spotted in the area.
And that's Hendrix.
We need officers near the Gotham Naval Research Facility.
Help me when you can. Just get up here, okay?
They'll never find your body, Batgirl.
I had a feeling this day was coming. You wouldn't believe the things that I heard at the hotel.
The court probably wanted to make sure you didn't talk.
Shit, they're real? That explains the masks. Look, one of my guys was feeding them info. And you know what? You should probably have all the same intel too.
Thanks. This is incredibly helpful.
This city is going to the birds, I swear.
Belfry, Hendrix is safe and sound. I have the data we need as well.
Excellent. Please return to the Belfry so we can evaluate next steps.
Gotta get to safety. I've uploaded the data we got from Hendrix. It should be ready soon. I've seen Bruce make that same face when he got stuck on a case. What's on your mind?
Everything starts with Ra's al Ghul attacking Batman, but I can't figure out how it connects.
You've never had to fight the League, have you? Ra's was a fanatic. He formed the League of Shadows centuries ago to root out corruption all over the world.
His philosophy, if he you want to call it that. That he should destroy things to build them back up. He's wiped out multiple cities over the centuries.
He set his sights on Gotham. Batman stopped him. He was impressed. So he named Bruce his heir.
That suddenly, even though Bruce said no thanks.
But it meant Ra's left Gotham alone. And that is until he showed up. Bruce.
Talia says Ra's was behaving erratically when he died.
Yeah. I put money on that not being the whole story.
Hang on. What if our starting point is earlier? Batman died while he was investigating the Court of Owls.
You think Ra's found out about it? But why come after his heir?
Ra's cares about two things. Rooting out corruption and protecting the Lazarus Pits. So if the Court was using an extract from the pits to create talents...
Ra's blows a gasket, steps in himself. Things escalate. Both he and Bruce end up dead.
And without Batman keeping a lid on Gotham's corruption, the Court starts to stretch its wings.
The League follows Ra's to Gotham, and there's nobody to stop them from attacking the Court.
Gotham City becomes ground zero for a goddamn war.
And no Batman to save it.
I guess that's our job now.
Yeah. It is. And we know what we need to do. We root out the Court. And we keep the League away from Gotham.
I really miss him.
Excellent. The drive Mr. Hendricks provided us contains exactly what we need.
The Orchard Hotel.
The balcony door should be open. That's your entry point.
A penthouse. You went all out on this one, Belfry.
Let's not make a habit of this. We don't have access to Bruce's credit cards anymore.
Belfry, I'm in. Time to find some owls.
Good. The party's already started. Find a good spot to eavesdrop on the ballroom, somewhere no one can see you. No one can know you're there.
There's the ballroom. Looks like the party's in full swing.
The hotel always under renovations. I paid for five-star service, not to smell plaster all day.
We're making some improvements, ma'am. I'll let the hotel manager know back to
see you. You'd better.
Just me, or is there more security this year?
This must be the entrance. Why else would they put this here?
You saw the elevator. The hotel doesn't have a 13th floor.
Don't mind me.
We'll impress the voice tonight. I'm sure of it.
Belfry, I disabled the security systems.
Good job. The guards outside the control room were planted there by the court, so you can punch with impunity.
I can feel it! No! Someone's here! Everything looks fine.
She's making a break for it!
Ready for this? Brilliant!
Outside the ballroom. Heading in now.
Well done.
Did you sign the guest book? How could I not? I've got people to impress. Did you see some of the names in there?
I did. Senators, judges, CEOs, even the mayor's here.
Business is good. Great eating. Who would have thought this would give the rest of us such a kick in the pants?
Sorry to interrupt, but it's time.
Of course. We'll have to continue this later.
That's a match.
Of Gotham, may I please have your attention? It is my absolute pleasure to present our host for the evening.
That has to be the voice of the court. He's not even trying to be subtle.
Thank you all for the warm welcome. But tonight is not about me. We are here to remember one of Gotham's greatest sons, Bruce Wayne. Now, you all knew the Playboy. I knew his charity. A brash defender of Gotham's best. Though he's gone now, Bruce's contributions to this city will be felt for decades to come. This is for you, Bruce. The last of our precious Wayne family. You've helped us in ways you never realized. And may we, the surviving families of Gotham, strive to live up to your inimitable legacy.
Voice of the court.
Awesome. If you follow him, we might be able to figure out who he is.
Sir, the labs are requesting more Dionysium to meet their production deadline.
I'm aware. Arrangements are being made. Let them know that I expect the quota to be met. No excuses.
Thank you, sir.
arrangements we've made?
If it pleases the court.
Excellent. I'll see you downstairs.
Into a secret elevator. I can't track him.
Yep, I've lost the signal here too. Looks like he was between two floors when it went out. Batgirl, we just found a hidden 13th floor in the hotel blueprints. Maybe that's where the voice went.
This should take me to the 13th floor. Belfry, I found one of those weird court doors. This must be it.
Understood. Tread carefully.
Is hiding. So where did the voice go? Belfry, any clue where to go from here? Belfry? Nothing. There must be a jammer in here. Interesting. Looks like the voice called for a meeting. What were they looking at?
But it certainly cannot be underestimated. It is a predator after all. And so are we.
They actually pressed old court speeches on vinyl. Talk about analog. According to a judge, it could be enough for a conviction.
There's still plenty to clean. Destroy everything. Make it so Langstrom never existed. We must send a message. You are only an owl of the court. So long as you remain loyal to the court.
They say an owl can turn its head all the way around to better see what is behind it, or might be trying to sneak up and strike. While we walk the halls of power with our heads held high, our true purpose hides inside the walls around us. Our court whispering into each other's ears like Cyrano on a date with destiny. A court of owls is watching from inside of Gotham's walls. This is a literal truth, as we build our perfect nests below the skins of our perfect city.
I recognize some of these names. These people are either dead or missing. Langstrom's in here too. This must be a hit list. Of Gotham architecture. The court must have been involved in the construction of these buildings. I'd recognize GCPD Central anywhere. City Hall.
Thank you.
Getting closer, these all represent different kinds of power structures in the city. No wonder the court's interested in them.
Of course. I should have known it was you. It's high time we talk.
Well, where are you?
Go. So you made it here, all by yourself.
You think I'd let you destroy Gotham without a fight?
Destroy Gotham? No, we're trying to save her. Preserve her glory. I understand now the potential you could have to do the same.
You're not the first masked villain to try to sell me that line.
The only one hiding behind the mask
is you, Ms. Gordon.
Jacob?
I know. Just like I knew my nephew Bruce was out there, keeping the peace in his armored pajamas. Don't worry, I didn't tell anyone. Call it loyalty to Martha.
We all live double lives, trying to shelter the city from chaos. It's just, our court is quieter about it.
You're not protecting this city. You and your cult are using it as your personal playground.
Yeah, Batman would probably say the same thing in your position. That's why I never told Bruce about the court.
We have the same ends, the same enemies.
It's madness. You're not serving us.
Unlike you, I don't kill people.
A difference in tactics, I'll admit.
I know you killed Langstrom, then his assistant. Is that what you call protection?
Those who betray us
will suffer for it. Langstrom betrayed the court.
Bruce fought for something bigger than himself. You just want power. He never would have allowed this.
Do not use my nephew against me. I mourn Bruce. I want answers for his death, just like you.
Don't compare us, Jacob.
Understood. I protected Bruce, but I won't protect you. If you won't join us, I'm afraid you'll have to join Langston. Clearly, I have bigger problems right now.
Just stay out of my way. You won't like what happens next.
Crap! Have to get back to the ballroom. League of Shadows is here.
Understood. Paramedics have been called.
How is that possible? God damn it! That girl! It's a massacre! Okay, let's do this. Take this!
Oh!
about to enter the hotel, I'd suggest a quick exit.
Montoya, it's Batgirl.
I take it you heard what happened at the hotel.
Actually, I was there.
Yeah? Then care to tell me who the hell those assassins were?
That was the League of Shadows. I'll send you everything we have on them.
The slaughter of some of our best and brightest at the Orchard Hotel is a new low for the city of Gotham. It is time for the real heroes, the GCPD, to step up and restore order in our city, to take it back.
Yeesh.
Surprisingly, Commissioner Kane isn't a match for any of the voices we collected.
Hey!
She may not be a court member, but the commissioner could still be helping them. She did marry Jacob.
Catherine is probably not aware of her husband's secret.
I know Jacob well, and have never had even the slightest suspicion.
Colonel Asshole fooled everyone. Even Bruce.
The other people we matched at the ball. John Wycliffe, Isabella Haas, Maria Powers.
All killed at the hotel by the League.
Colonel Kane's the only member we know survived for sure. And probably old Lady Cobblepot. She's unaccounted for.
And the court is clearly much bigger than Jacob Kane and Constance Cobblepot.
The almighty voice was right, you know. No one will believe a nursery rhyme's been pulling Gotham's strings for so long.
But people will believe that Jacob Kane conspired to murder Langstrom. We have the evidence to prove it. Let's get this to Detective Montoya. See if it's enough for her to build her case.
I'll be sure to include our list of known members, dead or otherwise.
We need to be careful about this. Jacob will be waiting for us to try something.
Someone should talk to Talia. The court and the League are clearly out to kill each other.
And let's be ready when we're caught in between them.